lot of commotion around here because of different people, mostly also politicians and the rescue team are around. They're trying every different mean. They're trying everything possible to ascertain the damage. But God willing, what you're being told is that nobody so far ameweza kuumia. The injuries are so minimal. Remember from when it started, tulikuwa tunaambiwa that a few people walikuwa stranded, four of them, two were kids ambao walikuwa stranded in the house. But what we're being told now that is that everybody has been rescued from the scene. Hakuna mtu ambaye amesalia humo ndani, because only four people that were not accounted for. But as of right now, we're being told that everybody has been evacuated and the people that were in this building have all been removed. And in mjengo ambao, if you look at it, it's a very decent building. But nowadays you can never tell by the looks, because you're being told that a two-bedroom apartment in the said building costed somebody 35,000 Kenyan shillings every month. Just imagine. And looking at it, it's a very big vicinity, because on the other hand you can see those are different houses and those are different buildings built in another different dimension apart from how this one was built. So a lot of things are going on, and the Red Cross team is around here. Yeah, and while the kule mnaona. Yeah, and the governor of Nairobi, Governor Johnson Sakaja, made a statement in regarding to what has happened here in Udhiru and what his government is doing to ascertain the damages and to help those people that have been affected by the damages. Yaona ni mjengo mbao. But there's something that is currently ongoing in Udhiru, and you'll allow me to say that, because today we spent actually a whole day in Udhiru, somewhere ambapo we have had landslide, somewhere where the landslide went ahead to cause very big damage, ambapo ni mchanga maporomoko yaliweza kufanya a certain how should I put it, maporomoko yaliweza kufanya a certain nini ikaweza kuzama. The point is, this is not normal. What is happening in Udhiru right now isn't normal. I see what is happening in Udhiru right now isn't normal. Reason being, leo tu tulikuwa somewhere around the said area where we witnessed a few things happening, and one of the many things that were happening ni, it seems that, now look at it, look at this ona mle ndani mle hizo ni chuma ambazo zilikuwa zimeshikilia mjengo wenyewe. Si mchezo. It's not easy. Now there is no way, there is nothing that will be done to this building. Only they will have to crash it down again, demolish it fully. Au kumbuke mali za watu zimo ndani. Not that bad.
That's a
So hizi ndizo pillars zilikuwa zimeshikilia nyumba. Looking at it, you can tell that somebody aliamua kuutilize pesa, kuminimize pesa. The contractors maybe, or the engineers, because how can you tell me that Unajua hii ni mchanga tupu, hii ni koroga ndio imeshikilia na tuchuma kidogo kidogo ndio imeshikilia hii mjengo wote.
Angalia mbele kwa chuma. Zile chuma zimetumika hapo.
Very minimal and they are very small. You know, chuma za kushikilia mjengo kwa ground na ni nyumba inajengwa ikiwa ghorofa, they shouldn't be like this. Alafu bati ya Mungu hapa hamkuwa na watoto ambao wanacheza or something, because the damage would be so big.
Sasa ukiangalia hii side nyingine unaona kuna mjengo mwingine bado unaona kama ilikuwa inaendelea.
And it seems, alafu, if you look at it, utagundua, by there, I was trying to say that leo pia tumekua huku Udhiru, and the things that are happening in Udhiru right now, ni vitu ambazo they are supposed to be looked at, because you can't tell me that kumekua na hizo barabara kwa tunaona zinapasuka, and now this is a building that has collapsed. There is something that is happening. Maybe the tuseme kitu kama ile pressure yenye inafosinge earthquake iko very high at this point in these areas.
The evacuation process ni kama wamemaliza da.
They have started packing and exiting the sea. Even for us, we are risking being here by day.
Hizi nyumba za siku hizi, you don't know where you're standing, what might happen next. The disaster management team. And Azuma, they make sure that everybody that was in the building has been accounted for. Najua kuna wale labda waongeleshangi majirani, so maybe wanaweza kuwa wamesahaulika. So that's what they are trying to ascertain. So that everything has been taken care of. Telling you from whenever you're watching us from, popote ambapo unatutazama ukiwa, make sure una subscribe, una like na una comment into our videos. Yeah, we doing this for you. Stima ilibidi ikatwe the whole nini, because the damage pia stima ingekosa hapa. Unaona hizo ni stairs mle juu, those are stairs pale.
Na hizo zimeanza.
By the way, hawa watu wamesurvive kwa hii nini, and by grace of God. It's by grace of God. Inakaa decent sana.
very decent build. Maskia wanalipa 35,000 a month. Is it a joke? 35,000 for building in Udhiru, for two bedroom in Udhiru, ni classy, you know? It's classy.
Kwanza ile kitu nimeshtua ni aje hapa. I think mwenye hii nyumba
yeah, it's own, the same one. Hata ukiangalia the rangi, the same.
Ya rangi ni same. Na unapata kuna nyingine na pesa.
And maybe the foundation is the same. But hii, unajua uzuri ya hii, you know, this one ilikuwa imetengenezwa venye chini huku ni parking or something, ama? Imagine gari ya mtu ilikuwa imepakiwa hapo chini. But after some bites, sawa.